Putin has a different world leader that he will be greeting soon, Prime Minister Netanyahu, on his way there. Netanyahu will push for all Iranian forces to be removed from Syria, period. According to multiple reports in American and Israeli media, Putin has agreed to keep Iranian forces at least 25 miles away from the Israeli border, but Netanyahu and his defense minister publicly have balked at that idea, saying Iran's efforts to have any kind of permanent presence there must be dealt with no matter the specific distance. Back now to Moscow with Jessica King. Jessica, for years, Putin has had this policy of looking the other way, but if Putin will not agree for a complete and total withdrawal of Iran, can that policy continue? Could he still allow Israel, as it sees fit, to run these airstrikes?
Well, as you say, I think Netanyahu is coming here with a very clear, strong message saying that these pro-Iranian forces should be sent home completely. But from Russia's side, they only appear willing, as you say, at the moment to allow pro-Iranian forces not allowed to come any closer to Israel's borders. You mentioned some of the specifics there. But in the past, they have called a complete withdrawal of Iranian forces completely unrealistic. And they've also called Iran's presence in Syria legitimate and undeniable. So there is definitely not a meeting of eye to eye on this. And perhaps Netanyahu is here to try and persuade Russia further to try and take on board some of Israel's strategic concerns. But as we've said in the past many times, Russia does see itself as a real key player, a key peacekeeper perhaps in the region. They support Bashar al-Assad's government. Of course, they have this close tie with Israel, but also with Iran and with Turkey through the Astana process. And we've just heard recently from the Russian foreign ministry that another Syrian reconciliation meeting in the Astana format, so that's the Russia, Iran and Turkey guarantors of that, is going to be held later this month. So Russia still seemingly trying to juggle the concerns of all its strategic partners at the moment.
Yeah, Russia has a lot of interests in the Middle East. I want to ask, this is the ninth meeting with Putin in the last 3 years alone, plus countless phone calls. Just the relationship between these two men on a personal level, going to the World Cup game tonight after they talk about Iran. I mean, how important is that, the way they get along and the way that they can come to some kind of understanding on the future of the Middle East?
Yes, well, I think it's interesting, of course, the timing that we talked about. You know, we've got the NATO summit going on, and Netanyahu seems to be here at very sort of key moments in Russian life. I mean, he was here in May for the very important Victory Day parade, almost standing side by side with Putin in what is one of, if not the most important date in the Russian calendar, a big parade through Red Square marking the end of the Second World War. He's here again for the big sort of second semi-final of the World Cup. So he is here at sort of quite high-profile events alongside President Putin. And I think that does, you know, show some sort of indication of the relationship that they are forging. But of course, very complex issues on the table today. And Russia still trying to balance its sort of obligations and its own sort of desires and needs in the region with all of its strategic partners. So yes, it's going to be a very tricky sort of diplomacy effort from Russia, I think.